Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophonet and welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. I moved a bit further than where we started off from, where we ended off in the last episode. So the previous campfire is down there somewhere. You can't really see it right now because of the blizzard going on, but we're pretty close to the fort where we need to be. I'm just gonna get a bit more supplies on the way and then we should be fine. Because, yeah, we cleared out the corrupted zones in the previous episode, and now we're nearing a certain fort, and this looks pretty awesome, actually. Is this the fort where I'm heading? Because the marker says over there, but...
Something attacked the Karja fort?
Apparently it is. Being attacked. Ooh, that is another corruptor. Let's just try and take it out.
Girl. These machines are dangerous!
Oh, snap. No, I know I can't enter this location. Is this a corrupted scrapper? Interesting. Oh, shit. Can't take this one out. Oh, it exploded. Or something. There we go. Oh, God. So I killed the scrapper, but now this thing is still on my ass. Now watch this down, and now the freaking corruptor. I'm gonna try out my sharpshot bow. So these break a lot, and these a bit less. So I am going to go for break and try and take out his. Damn it! There we go. That did nothing. What the hell did those do? Because it doesn't seem like it's doing... Ooh, wow. I'm out of healing items. So I should go for the potions next. There we go.
Truly, the sun shines upon us this day.
Whew.
Wasn't the sun risking its ass down here?
Yeah, indeed. Thank you, Halo, for that. So I don't really know how those air blast arrows work. So they should be removing stuff from its body, but apparently that didn't really work the way I expected it to work. Yeah, never mind. We killed it. Yeah, we're going to. But I wanted to check out. It was, yeah, the scrapper over here probably. No, that's the corrupted watcher. Another corrupted watcher.
Girl, come closer.
And then some metal burn. Oh, there's a corrupted scrapper. Not that much stuff. Thought that scrapper would have more stuff, but yeah. Okay, let's approach the gate.
So, will you open the gate for me now?
You heard her. Open the gates and send word to Captain Balon.
Captain
Balon.
Where
are you headed, girl?
West to Meridian.
Open the gates.
Ooh.
The way of broken stones is a hard run, even in the best of times. You might want to have a word with Captain Balon.
You guys look
Meridian
awesome.
Not long ago. You find him in the fort, on a balcony to the left, overlooking the valley.
Okay, thanks.
We're the ones who should be thanking you for taking down those machines. Walk in light, Nora.
So these guys, their armor kind of looks like Spartan armor mixed with Japanese armor? So samurai, kind of? Fought back to corruption, indeed. I think I'm just gonna, yeah, drink a health potion. Just so that we're safe. And now we completed that quest, apparently. I thought so. Now the next quest is go to Meridian. I'm not going to do that just yet because we left a lot of tasks available in the mother area, so in the area that the Nora tribe controls. But I'm going to quick save. And then I thought they told me to talk to a commander here. Can I go in there? Seems like we can. That's a Carter guard, and there we go. There's a few quests available in here as well. So that's probably Balan. Hello, Balan.
Captain,
you don't
Balan,
wear a helmet.
The guard at the gate said you've been to Meridian recently. What can I expect on the trail?
Nothing good. More machines all the time, and our scouts report corruption that way as well. So much for sealing things off. Keep to the roads. They're safe enough. Though after what you did at the gate, I'll wager you don't scare easy. It's a good quality.
Thank you.
I could put it to use, if you don't mind a quick jaunt back east. I know it's bold of me to ask a favor after you just did one, but I can offer you answers in return. If there's anything you need to know about the Sundom.
Oh, that is interesting. A favor.
What do you need, Captain?
I sent several patrols east when we got word of corrupted machines there. I'll let them confirm my fears, so I sealed the gates. But it looks like we left some men behind when they were closed. Waleed, tell them what happened.
Machines attacked us near an abandoned Nora village, sir. Lakir told us to pull back. Then I lost sight of the others.
And then you just left them there, apparently.
Before, soldier? Have some respect. Report to her, not to me.
Lakir always stresses reporting back, so that's what I did. I felt terrible about leaving them behind.
Well, now that the gates are open again, I can send someone after them.
Okay, so why me then?
Can't you send more soldiers to find the missing men? What about Waleed here?
Most Nora still don't take well to the sight of Karja armor. Officially, it's a risk to send patrols so close to your sacred land. I'd prefer not to do that again. But heading that way won't be a problem for you.
Please say yes.
What was
Please
that soldier?
Say yes.
Nothing, sir.
That was awesome. Underneath his breath, he said, please say yes. Please say yes. Do you know
Did
Olin?
An
yes.
Did named Olin come through here?
Twice. He was part of the royal delegation to the Nora, and they passed through on the way, then back. They brought back stories of a vicious attack on your people. My condolences, of course.
Do you know where Olin is now?
As he was
Not
part
exactly.
of the attack.
But he was on his way to Meridian, I'm certain of that. Everyone goes to Meridian.
Apparently they do. So, the way to Meridian?
Is there anything more you can tell me about the road to Meridian?
Sun King Avad has devoted considerable resources to making it safe. But by the Sun's witness, it's been harder to control in peace than it was during the war. Machines grow more dangerous all the time. Add to that, bandits and new reports of this corruption. We're stretched thin to protect a few outposts like this one. As for everywhere else, well, travel at your own risk.
Fair enough. Sounds like something we knew already. Questions about the Karja Sundom. I think we can ask those if we do the favor for him, so I'm not going to go in deeper right now. So I'll keep an eye out for your
I'll
men.
I'll see what I can do about your missing men.
I will be grateful, but not as grateful as Waleed. You hear that, lunkhead? You might be off the hook.
That was awesome. So yeah, I do find it interesting that you can't really deny any request you start a conversation about. Because in The Witcher, for example, you can say no to any quest you come across, but yeah, here they just let you accept. Can I check that out? There's no stealing in this game, right?
Melted snow.
Take all, metal shards, thank you very much. I'm just actually stealing her money here, but this lightweight bow rates power for faster reload and firing time, and is good for short to medium range combat. Fire arrows can ignite blaze canisters, and backpacks can be modified. There's another type of arrow available in that one as well. I'm just gonna wait and maybe buy some armor, because we've been holding that off for quite some time. I do want to have the Silent Hunter thingy, so I might just go for a minor upgrade to the Nora Silent Hunter medium. That should allow me to be a bit more stealthy, and I kind of like the look of it. So yeah, let's buy that and equip that immediately. Yes, there we go. And I think that's pretty much it. I'm just gonna grab his sample box, and there we go. Oh, look at that. Immediately equipped. We look kind of cool. It does look like we would be blending in with the grass easier. What's this? Okay, metal shards and chill water. That kind of looked blue on my screen, but might have been just me. And yeah, so we picked up that one quest for the commander here, but I don't know if there's anything else. It doesn't seem like there is. Can I actually go inside? No. They're just fancy doors, and there's another box here. I saw it. Metal shards and bony meat. Do I need to do anything? Ooh, what's this? The Derangement. Parchment scroll of glyph text. Let's check that out. The Derangement. The Derangement of the Machines. So the Derangement of the Machines is the... well, the effect that the machines are getting more and more aggressive. So, esteemed lords and ladies of the Sun Court, honored kings and patrons. Your concerns regarding the continuing derangement of the machines are noted. Though many seasons have passed since the first sightings of this frightful change, the Sun King is well aware that this is no longer a matter of reports from border patrols and Hunter's Lodge expeditions. One needs only look to the abandoned estate lands, indeed the estates you owned, left for the jewel to reclaim, or to the empty freeholds of the common Karja folk. Know that the Sun King has taken every measure to protect Holy Meridian and the Maze Lands with renewed patrols. As for entreating the Sun, we believe the cause of the derangement cannot be the Sun's displeasure alone, for the years of sacrifice under Sun King Duran produced no noticeable effect on the machines. His Luminance and the Sun Priests are in agreement that even if this is an ordeal set for us by the Sun, our suffering will not be reduced with blood. For your edification, I will recount what we have observed of the derangement. Of the simpler machines, the herd creatures, the gallopers, the scuttlers, where once they fled at the sight of men, now they are more likely to charge. The larger creatures, once only a menace to the inebriated and foolhardy, can be seen to lunge at the unwary with murderous intent. This is to say nothing of the coming of the Sawtooth, or its metal brethren, the Ravager, the Stalker, or that terrible giant, the Thunderjaw. So that's a lot more types that we've seen so far. Each one has proved a more capable killer of man than the last, each wielding a wider array of strange weapons. The wilds are no longer safe due to the hostility of these new machines. Though to date they have not attacked a settlement within the Sundom. That is interesting. Outlanders have brought no shortage of fanciful explanations for this behavior. Some suggest that the machines have come to resent men for hunting them. Not a bad idea, we've said as much as already. Yet such a thing has never been witnessed among beasts of flesh and blood, and they are proven to be more capable of thinking and memory. Karja hunters and Osram tinkers alike have attempted to understand the phenomenon by inspecting felled machines. But these appear no different to those harvested many years before derangement began, with the same assortment of wires, braiding, lenses, hearts, and so on. When these parts are subjected to the light of the sun or to Osoram experiments with fire and spark, they react as they always have. Subjected to the light of the sun? What does that even mean? The Banuk, however, claim to have recorded a change in the machine's songs, or the machine spirits, suggesting that these have become increasingly discordant. The Sun King has sent envoys to Banur to learn more in the hopes that their mysticism might contain a truth when the rational light of the sun is brought to bear upon it. Of course, the Sun King graciously welcomes your own contributions to study of the derangement, asking only that they are delivered in written form and not during royal audience. His Luminance also hopes to dissuade you from participating in machine hunts during these uncertain times. The strength of a united Sun Court is the strength of all Karja. Respectful Tashadi, Court Envoy. And that was a lot of information. So there's a fourth clan, the Banuk, I think they were called.
But it's decent work keeping the city safe.
That apparently have some kind of mysticism that might explain a bit more about the derangement of the machines. But yeah, right now I'm just gonna check out the quest log and see what we can do next, but I think I have a pretty good idea what we can do next. I want to check out the cauldron. So we heard Drawl's story in Mother's Crown, I think that was, and she found a cauldron, a so-called cauldron, and she wants us to investigate. So I'm just gonna try and fast travel over there, well, as close as possible as I can, and I'll see you guys over there. So I'm moving towards the cauldron, and I'm just gonna quick save here, and there's a lot of grazers nearby, so I wanna be careful, but look at this lighting. The moon just shining overhead, this is This is really, really awesome. Just gonna select my standard bow and try to move past these grazers, because I don't want to antagonize them just yet. Don't have any beef with them. I killed a few on the way though.
Got
just
one.
Because I could use the supplies. Seems like there's a lot of water nearby as well. What is this? Witchwood. Can always use that. Yeah, I do like how the knights look in Horizon Zero Dawn. They're just freaking amazing visually. What the hell? No. So there's more grazers. And now we need to get across this bridge. And I must say, the stealthy armor really, really helps. I haven't been spotted yet, so yeah, I really like how they did that. So there's more grazers over there.
Looks like Lubavod's men had to abandon some of their goods.
Striders. What is this? So this is probably what of that for that other side quest, where they left their... Ooh. There's a lot of dead watchers over here. Where they left their supplies and their fancy explosive arrows with that other merchant. So I'm just gonna follow this because
these watchers. I hope they haven't run into anything worse.
So yeah, indeed. So we're following the same track apparently. Might actually just quickly put that quest active in a minute. Although, you know what, I'm just gonna let this pan out more organically. So medicinal, can use that. Jesus Christ. I still need 3 arrows to kill boars for some reason.
What signal is setting off my focus?
And there we go. Ooh, that's 2 times the blue. The boar skin, that's really good because I need a lot of boar skin for my upgrades. Oh, and apparently I need boar skins for that quest as well. So, what are those? I think those are scrappers. Yeah, scrappers. So, and there's apparently a campfire over there as well. So might as well swing by here. Set that off really quickly. And then, so, there's another marker close by here. Oh, look at them. Here they are. So now we
you
need to
there.
Deliver the ammunition.
I hope you've come to help, because we're getting slaughtered out here.
Are you Marzavid? Marzavid, yes.
Lubavad sent me after you.
Oh, I see. And did he happen to tell you why he packed us a crate of Ridgewood instead of decent ammunition? 3 waves of watchers and scrappers so far, and worse to come. Without that ammo, we're good as dead.
Lubavod was worried.
Lubavod sent me because he was concerned for your safety.
The only thing that frightens Lubavod is losing an investment. We do the work, he counts profits.
Okay, why was there Ridgewood instead of the arrows? I thought you just made a mistake.
Lubavod didn't say anything about Ridgewood. He said you left the ammunition behind.
Then the old fool has gone cross-eyed. Every crate we loaded, I checked twice. The glyph said ammunition, but when we opened it, it was full of Ridgewood shafts and nothing but.
Okay, interesting. So here are your explosive arrows.
I have the ammunition with me. Enough for everyone.
By the sun, we might just stand a chance after all.
Alarms!
Yeah, there we go. I thought that was going to happen. I'm gonna have to help out a bit. Watchers, that's not bad, is it? What the hell is that? Is that a turkey?
2 arms! 2 arms!
A robo turkey. Yes. There we go, 1. Oh, the turkey is out for me. Jesus Christ. The target concussion sack. There's a lot of things glowing on this thing. There's 2 things on its back. Where the fuck is it? Okay. Might be time for one of my tear blast arrows. Okay, there we go. So that did tear it off. Oh, and that even works like that. Ooh, that is awesome. It just removes it. Holy shit, this guy is pretty aggressive. There we go. Four off. Whew. Where's the other one? I want to kill that one first, because these guys apparently have a bit of trouble. Ow. I'm out of arrows. Okay. Slam. Slam. Ooh, wow. That thing just exploded. Okay. How the hell?
More machines!
What the hell is going on? Okay, just gonna... Just gonna shock this guy, just gonna shock this guy and stab him to death. Ooh, wow. Jesus Christ, come on. This one's dead. And another one down, so the shock traps are doing everything they need to do. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Watch the flanks!
What flanks? Oh, wow. Maybe that flank. Okay!
That's what happens when you defy the Sundom.
Jesus Christ, that was suddenly a lot of animes. Scrapper, I just want to know how the turkey... Long leg. So that's a long leg. Long leg. Long leg lens. Jesus Christ, I can't talk anymore. Ooh. Scrapper heart. I'm just going to loot everything and I'm going to get back to you in a second. And there we go. That's pretty much it. I'm just going to quickly heal. I don't think I can... Oh, I can't talk to these guys again. So, hello, Marzovic.
You fight well, Outlander. I'm surprised Lubavard was willing to pay for someone of your skill.
Maybe he didn't know.
Me, actually. I did this for free.
Never trust the Karja merchant.
Yes, indeed.
Boss! The Songkors are gone!
What?
The Songkors?
Unless Dereed took them. When the first wave hit us, one of the men ran off. Dereed. I thought he was a coward. Turns out he's a thief, too.
He couldn't have gotten far.
True, but we're in no shape to go after him.
Then I'll get him for you. But this time, I get paid.
Quick learner, eh? Fine. Bring those Songkors back and you've got a deal.
Sounds like a plan, so... The under-equipped quest is not complete yet. How far away is that? What's this? No, that's not what we wanted to do. Under-equipped, this is the one. How far away is this? Find Dereed. Probably gonna have to... Is it this guy? Probably is, so... This does lead me away from the cauldron that I wanted to check out. But yeah, we're on this quest now, so I'm gonna just do this first. So I think we found Dereed. Because he's... Where did he? Yeah, there he is. Goddammit, in the snow, he kinda blended in. Hello, Dereed.
Hello, Dereed.
Who are you?
The caravan.
The words right out of me.
Caravan? What caravan?
The one you sabotaged. You figured no explosive arrows meant no survivors, no witnesses to your crime.
Look, stranger, I have debts. If I don't pay, the dicers will gouge out my eyes.
Not my problem. Oh! What the hell is that? Oh shit, this is bullet. Stalker, weakness, shock. Oh shit. Get over here, you pussy. Doesn't know where I am. Oh, and there's another thingy. Oh, did it? What? He went through my trap. So I can't scan it in this mode, so he's... He has a stealth generator, so I might want to take that off of him first. Yeah, that's a Tear Blast arrow, so that should remove his stealth capacitor.
That hurt it.
Goodbye. And then he was vulnerable to... Oh, yeah, okay. Jesus Christ. He's running, isn't he? I don't like that gun of yours. Think I hit it. There goes the gun. Now that motherfucker's just leaving. Stay still for 1 second. Oh, wait. Critical hit. Apparently that doesn't kill it. Okay then. Oh, he doesn't care, does he? Oh, there he goes. Goodbye. Just step back a bit, just in case he, just in case he explodes. But that was interesting. A stalker, so an invisible robot. This is getting cooler and cooler by the minute. Jump over that. Where's Dereed? Is he still alive? Oh, he looks like he's still alive. Whoo! This is the episode of the new machines.
Did they live?
Long yes. Legs and a stalker.
I got to them in time.
Thank you. As I turn and embrace the sun, may he burn away my sins.
Oh, goodbye.
What a waste. At least he died better than he lived.
Oh, wow. That was pretty harsh as well, but yeah. Song cores, thank you very much. And hunter arrows. Are those? Yeah, those are the standard arrows. Maybe make a few more shock wires. Those Tear Blast arrows are really starting to shine. Especially to take out abilities of machines, because that was pretty handy. So yeah, let's head back to the merchants. Well, the caravan. I'll see you guys in a second. So, our second death at the hands of a stalker. That's not too bad, I suppose. Hello, Marzovid.
And with the Sunkors, I see. And Dereed?
He kinda died.
Yeah, stalker got him. It wasn't pretty.
And you beat a stalker. That's worth a bonus. Here, take my share. You earned it.
That's awfully generous of you.
I'll see to the caravan from here. I think the rest of the trip will go smoother.
Interesting. Okay, thank you. That completed under-equipped. So I'm just gonna check out that remarkable reward box, of course.
A signal's nearby.
Yes, I know. I kind of already scanned it. Where is it? It's over there. So I might want to check that out in a minute as well. But first, inventory management. So, remarkable reward box. 26 metal shards, 5 metal burn, and 6 metal vessels. Not that amazing, but yeah, it's something at least. Anything else I should be doing? I don't think I should. I could actually modify my new outfit with resist fire, resist shock, 6%. No, thank you. I don't think it's really necessary. So yeah, let's head. So now I just put the go to Meridian quest. Oh shit, that was a bit much. Go to Meridian quest active, but I don't really want to go. Ooh, is that the cauldron? So yeah, I think I'm gonna take a little break, and when we get back, that is exactly where we're going to go, right in there, inside of the cold room. But that, we'll have to wait until next episode, so thank you guys enormously for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next episode, where we'll try and clear out that cauldron over there. So thank you very much. Goodbye. Yeah,